Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on how you can add SwiftUI-like elements in your UIKit apps. You heard that right, SwiftUI elements in UIKit. And today we are going to talk about text fields. Let's jump right into the code and see that we already have an image view. In the previous video, we have talked about images and how you can set this image view. It is really easy to do so, but today we are going to talk about text fields. Now, text fields are a real hard beast to master. So first of all, let me just delete all of these. Yeah, and maybe this one too. Okay, so we have our stack here. That's just what is remaining. And we are going to talk about text fields. So let's create one. So text field, let's say 0 equals UI text field. Text field, there we go. And yeah, that is just what I want. Maybe just add a debug there so we can see how that looks. Okay, let's just add it in there, add a comma, and let's build and run and see how that looks. Okay, and now you will see some disadvantages of using a simple UI text field. First of all, you have to have a width for it. So let's add a width there. Let's see, can we do that? Most probably we can. Let's see, set a width. Let's say 100, because we have that spacer there. Yeah, if you are going to take a look at the layoutless, the one that's called layoutless, and taking a look at dividers and spacer, you will understand how this works. I won't waste any time on it. So there we go. We have a divider and a spacer there. So here we have one, and if we tap on it, you can barely see there, but I will just type in here hello, and yeah, it's kind of there. But if you go back, it's starting right at the left boundary of our UI text field, and yeah, and that is what UI text field is all about. But if you wanted to, let's say, style it, add a border, it will start right there. So what I have created for you is a little subclass of UI text field, and it has everything that UI text field has, but even more, and that is called the text field. So let me just remove that, and it is called the text field. So I'm just building and running again, and now if I tap in it, you will see that we have some padding at the left. So hello, there we go, and it looks much better. And of course you can take a look at the dtextField swift file, and you will see that when we initialize it, we added some insets, and we have some default insets of left 12 and right 12, but you can add any insets when you initialize this. So let's see here, let me just go back here, text field, and we can add some insets, some UI edge insets of top, left, bottom, and so on. So I won't go into that. You already know how to do that. Okay, so that is how you can add some insets, but the text field has also some awesome extensions, and you can find all of those in the dtextfield plus swift file. And as you can see here, we have some text if you want to add that, placeholder, okay, background, corner radius, border width, border color, now border width with color, so both, auto capitalization type, and keyboard type, or is secure entry. And that is the 90% what you will need, and all of these can be chained to our text field. So let's say if we wanted to is secure entry, and we set that to true. Okay, now this is used for passwords, so yeah, let me just show you how we get those black dots. So there we go, I just start typing in anything, and yep, that's there. And of course you can use all of the other methods to And we can use, as you can see, SetWidth is a UIView extension. You could use on the text field any UIView extension that you can see on the UIView plus Swift file. So there you have it. Now you can create a dText field with a secure entry and so on. Okay, now in the next video, we are going to talk about text views and how you can add those larger, not just one line text field, and how you can react to them or maybe add them into a label, what you are just going to type in there. So, as usual, if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video. And I will see you in the next one.